life has a way of just unfolding what you need to know when you need to know it, and you'll be given what it is that you need to do. I think that's very true. It's certainly been the story of my life. Well, I grew up in Houston, Texas. My dad was an oil perforating tool engineer. Those were good years. I wanted to come to Baylor, and I came here for a year. I'd started out in business. I went back to the University of Houston and worked, and then I started figuring out one day how long it would take me to get my degree doing it that way, and I thought, ooh, I better save all my money and get back to Baylor. So I started out in religion, and then I took a course in drama in the theater, and I thought, oh my goodness, there's so much I can learn in this particular department. So I switched my major, got my degree, and then I finished up my graduate work, was offered a job as the business manager of the theater. Did that for 4 years and really loved it. During those years, I met my husband, and it was just time to start a family. The director of children's theater talked to Lou Ann Claris and me and said, I have a group of 40 children, ages about 7 to 17, and we did some plays at the Waco Civic Theater. What an awesome opportunity that was. St. Paul's was opening their new elementary school. They asked me if I would come and set up an arts and drama program there. And so I did that for 4 years. I kind of got into design work at home and ended up building a studio onto our house. And I had built this studio so that I could be at home when a car carrier came home from school. I didn't mean for this to become a business. I didn't exactly intend initially to sell my work, but people kept wanting to buy it. And then our two boys had graduated. I knew that both of them intended to come into the business. And about that time, Leslie asked me to come help with a meeting. When I got there, I realized he was so burned out. And I thought, everything that I've been learning all these years has been great preparation for helping him in the business. As Leslie was walking out the door, he said, okay, I did it 30 years by myself. Now it's your time to do it 30 years by yourself. Well, I laughed at the time. That was 35 years ago. I still go into the office every day. Love it. Car and Carrie will have to carry me out in a coffin. But when they do, they'll notice a smile on my face. I do love that business. We just have the greatest team of people working there. But we're blessed. We're very blessed. When I was chair of the chamber, I was advised that I need to go ahead and join the business league, and then I was chair of the business league. One of the things I heard was that the business community ought to be more involved. I think they could use another business person on the city council. So I started recruiting people. Finally, several people said, no, Virginia, you need to run. So I did, and I didn't have an opponent. May and I, the current mayor, became really good friends and started working together. She and I would, you know, talk about what we wanted the community to be like. 9 months into her term, she died. We were so shocked. Again, I got recruited. I'm running for mayor. And so I got Bill Clifton to be my campaign director. Bill Nesbitt was so helpful. He was the treasurer, and we all went to work. With a lot of help from my friends, as they said, I made it through.
I think the people that are the best leaders in our community are ones that have a servant's heart. Virginia wins that award in my view because when she retired from being mayor because she was term limited out, she didn't just stop. She formed the Education Alliance because she picked that as the thing that she thought she could help the most with, and that also there was the most need within our community.
I can't think of anybody that's done more for this community than Virginia. I've never seen anybody that can pick up an idea and take the ball and run with it for as long as she can. Quality of life, the leadership, the government, business relationships, business development, Virginia has been the leader we look to and we'll always look to for a long time.
Nearly every opportunity I've ever had has been somebody else's idea, and I've been invited into that or urged to do that. And so, you know, I can't say that I had this great vision that I went just plowing on through. I think it was just a series of opportunities that I was lucky. Somebody needed me at the right time and the right place, and I kind of thought, oh, that would be an interesting thing to do. So it worked out.